The verse begins, Allahu nuru samawati wal ard. Allah is the nur, the light of the heavens and earth. What is the meaning of this? Allah is the source of guidance in all of the heavens and earth. So nur is symbolic of hidayah. And this interpretation has plenty of evidence from the Quran and Sunnah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls the Quran a nur. وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ نُورًا مُبِينًا. Allah says in the Quran that Allah Azza wa Jal يُخْرِجُهُم مِّنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. Allah takes mankind from darkness and He takes him into light. So all guidance comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَهْدِ اللَّهُ لِنُورِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah guides to His nur anyone whom He pleases. The second interpretation of Allahu نُورُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings light to the heavens and earth, a physical light. Allah Azza wa Jal creates light, a physical light. So where does light come from? Allah gave us this light. And the third interpretation is that we take the ayah at face value. And indeed, Allah is light. Allah is nur in a way that Allah knows. Allah says in the Quran, وَأَشْرَقَتِ الْأَرْضُ بِنُورِ رَبِّهَا. This earth on the day of judgment will be set alight by the nur coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would pray in Qiyamul Layl and in Salat al-Tahajjud. He would say, Allahumma lakal hamdu anta nurus samawati wal ardi wa man fihin. Oh Allah, to you belongs all praise. You are the nur of the whole heavens and earth. Anta nurus samawati wal ardi wa man fihin. We all know what happened when Musa asked to see Allah. We all know the story, right? That Musa said, Rabbi arini anzur ilayk. And Allah said, لَن تَرَانِي, you cannot see me, but I will show myself to the mountain. If the mountain can withstand me, then you can withstand me. فَلَمَّا تَجَلَّ رَبُّهُ لِلْجَبَلِ جَعَلَهُ دَكَّا. When the mountain saw, the mountain crumbled and Musa fell unconscious. Allah is demonstrating, you don't have the power to withstand my beauty. إِنَّ اللَّهَ جَمِيلٌ إِنَّ اللَّهَ نُورٌ. Allah is the ultimate beauty, the ultimate light. So as a mercy to us, He has protected us from His beauty, from His radiance. How? Through a hijab of darkness? No. Even His hijab is light. Hijabuhu an-nur. مَثَلُ نُورِهِ كَمِشْكَاتٍ فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٍ. The example of His light. The example of His light. What is the light being referenced here? Perhaps the strongest interpretation is that of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala an, who said that the light of this ayah, مَثَلُ نُورِهِ, the example of His light, is the light of iman that Allah places in the heart of the believer. The example of His light, مَثَلُ نُورِهِ. What is this light referred to? The light that Allah has given in the heart of every believer. مَثَلُ نُورِهِ كَمِشْكَاتٍ فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٍ. The example of this light is like a niche. What is a niche? A niche is a crevice in the wall. Mishkat is a crevice in the wall. فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٍ. Inside this crevice is a candle. الْمِصْبَاحُ فِي زُجَاجَ. The candle is enclosed in a glass lamp. So imagine it, visualize it. That there is a crevice, there's a niche that's going in. And inside the niche, there is a lamp. And the lamp or the candle, it is enclosed in glass. So you have the crevice, you have the glass, you have the light. This is the example that Allah says, مَثَلُ نُورِهِ كَمِشْكَاتٍ فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٍ. الْمِصْبَاحُ فِي زُجَاجَ. الزُجَاجَ, this light, this crystal, this lamp. كَأَنَّهَا كَوْكَبٌ دُرِّي. This crystal itself is like it is a star that is set alight. Just the crystal, not even the light. The lamp that the light is in is itself a beautiful star, a radiant star. كَوْكَبٌ دُرِّي. يُوْقَدُ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ. The lamp, this misbah, where does the oil come from? The oil comes from a blessed tree. شَجَرَ مُبَارَكَةٍ. زَيْتُونَ, an olive tree. لا شرقية ولا غربية. This tree is neither found in the east or in the west. The oil that comes from this blessed tree, يَكَادُ زَيْتُهَا يُضِي. This oil is so pure and brilliant, the oil itself is about to give out fire even before the match touches it. وَلَوْ لَمْ تَمْسَسْهُ نَارٌ. Now, what is this symbolism here? How do we interpret all of this? One interpretation is the niche or the crevice represents the chest of the believer. Al-Mishkat. The Mishkat represents the chest of the believer. So this is the chest, literally. And the glass represents the qalb, or the heart. And the misbah itself, or the light itself, It represents the light of Iman from Allah. So the light of Iman is inside the glass heart, which is protected in the chest of the believer. This is the interpretation of Ibn Abbas and others. And to give the analogy of the heart as being glass is so profound, because what is glass? It is firstly see-through, and the heart of the believer is see-through. He acts and he deals as his heart is. The believer is not a hypocrite. The believer is a straight-faced man. If he's feeling angry or sad, you'll see it. He's not going to be double-faced. If he doesn't like you, he's not going to double-cross you. His heart is like a glass. Also, glass could be fragile and it could be more solid than a rock. Some people's hearts are fragile. Some people's hearts are very soft, soft as some types of glass. And some people's hearts are harder than rocks. So by giving the symbolism of glass, all of this is encompassed. The lamp, as we said, represents the light of Iman, the heart of the believer, that Allah has given light. And the tree, what is the tree? The blessed tree is the tree of the Quran. Where does the light come from for Iman? It comes from the Quran. The wahi itself, the revelation, is this shajara mubarakah. And that is why Allah says it's neither east nor west. It's not of this world. The Quran is from up above. The Quran is not from this world. لا شرقية ولا غربية. So the Quran is giving us the purest of pure oil. That oil is so bright, it doesn't need a match to light it up. But when it reaches our hearts, and when the light of the oil reaches the purity of the heart, what happens? Nurun ala nur. You have a double light, the light of the Quran and the light of the purity of the heart of the believer. The both of them add to one another. And that is why pure hearts always find Islam, even if they're non-Muslim. Pure fitras eventually are guided to Islam because they have nur, and then they see the nur of the Quran, and the two of them are put together. Nurun ala nur. Yahdi Allahu linurihi man yasha. Allah guides people to this light whomever He pleases. وَيَضْرِبُ اللَّهُ الْأَمْثَالَ لِلنَّاسِ. And Allah gives parables to mankind, and indeed Allah is aware of all things.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. الله نور السماوات والأرض. مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح. المصباح في زجاجة. الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يوقد من شجرة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار نور على نور نور على نور يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس والله بكل شيء عليم.